device called the Core Analyzer. I don't have access to the boundary blueprints, but I'll do my best to guide you there.
Sounds good. Mac, Seth, let's go. This place looks wrecked. An empty cell bot socket. Little guy must be around here somewhere. Kai, I'm in some kind of crush pit.
You're on the right track. Just have to get past the grinder.
You are? Come with me. first. Gone now. Come with me to your socket.
Certain materials are essential to the core production process. While rare on Earth, the crystalline structures we needed were in plentiful supply on Far Eden.
December 2083. It was good to rest, but even better to wake and see all the progress the core bots have made. The foundry is up and running, thanks to Victor, and exceeding core production targets. The pylons are ready for activation. And I've received news from the evacuation ships. They're safe, and about to start deceleration into the Far Eden system. Now that the communication lag is only days instead of decades, the mandate wants to send me a large data package. Firmware updates for the core bots. I'm not sure what they've created that they think will improve on my original design, but no matter. It's time for me to wake the other crews. I'm ready to tell them about Earth, because now, for the first time, I truly believe Far Eden can succeed.
find a way up. See what this console does. Come to me. Kwij, I see fire.
Must be the forge. Mac and Seth should be fine. Their frames have really high melting points. But you...
Got it. Don't touch the fire. The analyzer. Big ring in a big room?
That's it. Just put the prismatic core into the main console and we'll be all set.
like the power cores are missing.
There ought to be an incubation chamber nearby. You should find plenty of cores in there.
I don't have what I need to do that. What we got. A yellow ammunition upgrade. Nice.
Thank you.
incubation chamber.
What's it like? It must be incredible to see so many Groovy Forge cores.
Well, most of the cores are gone. This whole place looks torn apart. Just need one more. Let's head back to the analyzer.
Thank you.
The analyzer's up and running.
All right, let's check out that prismatic core.
Let's see what makes you tick.
Jewel, if anyone could set things right,
Dad,
I knew it would be you.
Dad! Kwij, did you hear that? There were voices coming through the core. Maybe it's some kind of transmission from the ships in orbit.
All I see on my end is a wall of mandate encryption. I don't have enough compute power in my crawler to crack it. But I know a place that does.
The core! It overloaded the analyzer.
You need to find a way to shut it off before it goes critical. The explosion could destroy the whole foundry.
Okay, I see some energy cells. They look like they're overheating.
Destroy them! Quick!
Going crazy.
There have to be more cells on the other side of the room.
It's okay, Seth. We can do this. Where do you think we can crack the mandate encryption on the prismatic core?
Far Eden Tower. It was built to control the terraforming process, so it's got to have plenty of compute power. There's a tram at the back of the foundry that leads straight to the E-Tower. I'll meet you there.
All right, sounds good. Seth, let's go.
Capacity, the foundry could produce hundreds of cores every month. From there, the cores would be boxed up and shipped all over Far Eden.
Rail. This must be the place. Yeah, Seth. That's quite a view. Must be at the E-Tower. This console should call it back. Alright, now we wait. Uh-oh. I guess someone doesn't want us going to the tower.
Thank you.
everybody still in one piece? Kwij?
Almost there. I'm fine, Sam. Just wanted to see what the parts you got me could do. The E Tower. The heart of Far Eden.
Looks shut down. Just like the pylon in the factory. But not for long.
Listen, Jewel. I didn't want to tell you over the radio, but the voices we heard didn't come from the ships in orbit.
What do you mean?
This might sound crazy, but I think the voices were coming from inside the core.
That core is mine!
So you're Victor!
Jewel, get out of here!
What?
Seth can take you and Mac back across the rail.
I'm not leaving you here with him!
Seth is not strong enough to take us all. You've got to keep the core safe, no matter what. There's no time to argue, Jewel. Go.
Bring me that core!
Another way into the E-Tower. Don't worry. Kwij can take care of himself. He's okay, I know it. He has to be. Come on, guys. Let's head to the E-Tower.
2084. They locked me out. Me, Julius Roldan. I no longer have access to the Prime Core. Has the mandate got insane? What if something goes wrong with the pylons? Who would keep the terraforming on track? The Core bots never had permission to access the Prime Core. The only people with access, besides me, would be the Eden Tower maintenance crews. But maybe... maybe that's what the mandate wanted all along. Yes. Yes, of course. Why didn't I see this before? There's a spy among the crews. Someone sleeping in their crawler, waiting for a mandate command to take control of this project. My project! If I don't know who I can trust, I trust no one. No one wakes. Not until I know exactly what the mandate has done.
Thank you.
the security gate Kwij told us about. But there's no way we can move those rocks. Let's see if we can find a different way through. Another crawler? I thought this zone was off limits. Hello? Is anyone here? Look at this. Victor. He did something to the core bots. And then he ordered them to attack the crawlers? Why would he do that? They cracked the tube. And then he never woke up. Both of you, wait! You drew that, didn't you? This is your crawler. Your companion inside the tube. Victor attacked the But you couldn't stop him on your own. Victor hurt my friend, too. His name is Kwij. What's your name? Duncan. I'm Jewel. This is Mac and Seth. No, they're not with Victor. They're with me. We're going to the E-Tower to stop Victor and save Far Eden. Will you help us? Good. And I know the first thing you can do. These frames were built for demolition, right, Duncan? Well, let's smash some stuff!
January 2084. Those mandate fools. The data package they sent didn't just affect the core bots. It modified the prime core as well. When I asked them why, they refused to answer. They said they accused me of overstepping my authority when I chose not to wake the other crews. When I explained why, they questioned my judgment. The same idiots who might have disabled every core bot on this planet and the entire terraforming system questioned my judgment? I refuse to accept any more of their transmissions until I can be sure they aren't hiding something else. If they want to insult me with more accusations, they can do it face to face when they reach Far East. For the next 5 years, I am still the leader of this project, and I will do whatever is necessary to protect it.
Place. No wonder it's off limits. The shifting sands. Better keep an eye out for storms. Duncan, over here. Duncan, take it out. There's the E-Tower. But how do we get there? Through the Warren? You mean the E-Turner refinery? Well, it won't belong to Victor Tom. Come on. Thank you. There. That must be the entrance. Duncan.
Worried about? It's happening, Jewel. And it's bringing out the worst in us. It's like the final act of all those sci-fi movies we used to watch. Dust Devil's mutation rate has increased. It's changing too fast for the drugs to keep up. The Band-Aid is starting to shut down facilities, and the staff members are all scrambling to make sure they've got seats on the evacuation ships.
Let's do this, Violet. Core needs to be stronger. Okay, Violet, let's go.
Speed up the colony construction process. The core bots would recycle materials from the ships that brought them from Earth. After all, none of us were planning to go back.
unfortunate that you have decided to ignore my request. I admit, I didn't expect any thanks for my advice. But with all due respect, Dr. Roldan, you are even more stubborn than your file suggests. After all the discrepancies we've observed, are you really going to allow the same core bot that almost destroyed the engine to try and repair it? As I have told you repeatedly, mission protocol clearly states that all repairs to critical components must be overseen by human personnel. I'm well aware that conditions inside the engine pod are dangerous, and I admire your desire to safeguard the human members of your crew. But leaving this work up to a core bot risks mission failure. You're traveling at near light speed in a sophisticated spaceship, not cruising down the highway in your car. If something goes wrong, I will not be held responsible. Do you understand?
Good.
This ought to be good. Let's do this, Violet. Here.
Thank you.
Nice! It worked! Sweet. Oh, yeah.
Thank you.
Hey, Violet.